Hi everyone, Steve here from Photoshop Essentials. As of Photoshop 2026, Google's Gemini 2.5, or Nano Banana, is now available in Generative Fill, and you can do amazing things with it. But Nano Banana has an alignment issue, or a misalignment issue. It tends to shift things out of place. You've probably run into this yourself, but let me show you what I mean. I want to replace the man's glasses. So I'll zoom in closer to my image. I'll grab the rectangular marquee tool, and I'll drag a selection around his face. Now, Nano Banana has a resolution limit of just 1024 by 1024 pixels. So whenever you can, it's best to select around the area you want to change rather than selecting the entire image. But keep in mind that Nano Banana will only see the area inside your selection. It won't see anything outside the selection. So if you don't include enough of the area to give Nano Banana some context, it may have trouble with the result. I'll click Generative Fill. And for my prompt, I'll type replace the man's glasses with oversized yellow sunglasses. For the model, I'll make sure I have Gemini 2.5 or Nano Banana selected, and then I'll click Generate. And here's the problem. Nano Banana did replace his glasses, but it also stretched the result and messed up the alignment. If I turn the generative layer on and off, we see that the result was stretched vertically. His shirt doesn't line up, the background doesn't line up, and his face looks longer and thinner than it was before. Now, you can try to fix this manually by changing the generative layer's blend mode from normal to difference. With difference, any areas that are aligned are in black, and areas that are not aligned are in color. If you go to the Edit menu and choose Free Transform, you can drag inside the box to try to center things, and drag the handles to resize it, trying to remove the color and get things lined up as much as possible. I'll click Done to accept it, and then I'll switch the blend mode back to normal. I'll toggle the layer on and off, and it's better, but it's still not aligned. Now, depending on your image, sometimes this manual adjustment works really well, but in this case, not so much. So I'll undo all of that by pressing Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac a few times. And we're back to the original problem. And let me show you another way to work, one that lets Photoshop align things automatically. If we go to the Edit menu, notice that we have an option called Auto-Align Layers, but it's grayed out. And that's because Auto-Align Layers won't work with a generative layer. So the solution is to rasterize the generative layer. But before I do that, I'll quickly make a copy of the layer so we can compare the results. And I'll turn it off for now. Then I'll right-click on the original generative layer and choose Rasterize Layer. Now, auto-align layers still won't work unless we have two layers selected. So I'll hold my Shift key and click on the background layer to select them both. And now I can go to the Edit menu and choose Auto-Align Layers. In most cases, you can leave it set to Auto and just click OK. And Photoshop tries to align the contents of both layers. And it looks like it did a pretty good job. If I toggle the sunglasses on and off, we see that it's still not perfect, but it's better than what I was able to do manually, and much better than that initial Nano Banana result. There's still an issue with the shirt and with the background, but all I really need are the glasses, so I can hide everything around them that Nano Banana generated. The easiest way to do that is to place my sunglasses layer into a layer group, and then add a layer mask to the group. So I'll click on the sunglasses layer to select it. Then I'll click the Layers panel menu icon and choose New Group from Layers. I'll name the group Glasses and click OK. And now that layer is inside the group. To add a layer mask, I'll make sure the group is selected. Then I'll click the Add Layer Mask icon. And this adds a layer mask filled with white, which keeps the group visible. I want to hide the contents of the group. So in the Properties panel, I'll click the Invert button. And this fills the mask with black, and the sunglasses are hidden. To bring back just the sunglasses, I'll select the Brush tool from the toolbar. I'll make sure my foreground color is set to white so I can paint on the mask with white. Then I'll right-click in the document and make sure the hardness of the brush is set to 0. So I'm painting with a soft-edge brush. Then I'll resize my brush using the bracket keys on my keyboard. And I'll paint over the area to reveal the new glasses. If I toggle the group on and off, it looks like the new glasses are a little too high on his face. So I'll switch to the Move tool. I'll make sure I have the layer group selected, and I'll lower the opacity of the group so I can see through it to the original image. And then I'll use the arrow keys on my keyboard to nudge the glasses into place. And that looks better. Again, if we compare it with the original Nano Banana result, at this point, things are looking good. I'll zoom back out by going up to the View menu and choosing Fit on Screen. And I'll delete that copy of the sunglasses by dragging it onto the trash bin. So auto-align layers was great for fixing the alignment issue with the sunglasses. But that's because the area I was replacing was not along the edge of the image. Watch what happens when I try to change the color of the man's shirt. This is where Nano Banana's alignment issue really becomes a problem. I'll drag the taskbar out of the way. And keep an eye on this area of the shirt near the bottom edge. I'll make sure I have the Rectangular Marquee tool selected, and I'll drag a selection around the shirt. And then I'll click Generative Fill. I'll type Change the shirt color from yellow to green. I'll leave the model set to Nano Banana, and I'll click Generate. And at first, it looks like Nano Banana did a good job, except that, again, it stretched the image vertically. But because it stretched the image, we now have a problem. Some of the shirt along the bottom edge was cut off. If I turn the layer off, there's the original shirt. And if I turn the layer back on, there isn't much of the shirt left. Watch what happens when I use auto-align layers. I'll right-click on the generative layer and choose Rasterize Layer. And since the other layer I need to select is the bottom layer, and I don't want to select that layer group in between, I'll hold the Control key on my keyboard or the Command key on a Mac and click on the bottom layer. So now that I have both layers selected, I can go up to the Edit menu and choose Auto Align Layers. I'll leave it set to Auto and click OK. And there's the problem. Photoshop actually did a great job. It aligned the shirt where the two layers overlap. But because Nano Banana stretched the shirt beyond the bottom edge, the bottom of the green shirt is missing. So I would need to either crop the image or go back and try again. So that's just something to keep in mind. Hopefully, we'll see an update that fixes the alignment issue, but in the meantime, auto-align layers can usually do a pretty good job. So I hope you found this video helpful, And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.